Stevenson gets the 19-14 win over Lebanon Valley here tonight at Mustang Stadium. Glenn Clark with head coach Kathy Railey. Coach, there were 3 minutes left in the first half. Your team was down 9-6. Admittedly, we were talking in the booth, like, well, you just want to make sure you're not down by 4 or 5 at the half. You were up by 1 at the half. Can you describe those final few minutes of the first half and how they changed this game?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I'm so proud of this group. You know, they really trust in the process of what we're trying to do. I was never worried, to be completely honest with you. I really thought we were doing the right things. I knew that we'd only practiced this defense a day or two. I knew that we'd only practiced this offensive play a day or two. I knew it would click because we're that kind of high IQ players. So I was patient more, and people don't say that about me ever, but I was patient in the process, and it ended up, you know, helping us win the game, I think. And what a spark going in at halftime. With, you know, Carol's shot that was so good, and, you know, right at the buzzer beater at halftime, that really gives the mental advantage to the team, you know.
There's no doubt.
Yeah.
No doubt. All right, a few things that jump out at me. One, I know every team is different. I understand all of that, but we all know what happened the last time.
Oh, my goodness.
How much was that a factor? How much did it mean to everybody to come out and sort of erase some of those demons?
You know, I think we had the demons in the first half still. I think that, you know, Lebanon Valley is a good team. They are crisp passers. They cut hard. They can shoot right-handed and left-handed. They're a tough team to defend. But I did think at the end of the day that we would outlast. I thought that we would get better and better in the way to stop where their talents are, how to stop them in their talents. We just needed to let it play out. So I think it feels really good for me in particular because I did not sleep for an entire summer. There's no doubt that this junior class, who, you know, that is probably the most memorable game that they've ever had in their career. To avenge that is something super special.
And there were a lot of former players that were checking in that were grateful for
it, by the way.
It meant a lot to them. We're going to talk to Caroline and Kaitlyn. I want to spotlight Kaitlyn for a second because I thought tonight was the example of everything that she does, from the draw to the defensive plays, to obviously finishing with 4 goals.
Right.
I know that there's been a standard here. There's been a lot of players in recent years that are capable of all that. But what does it mean to a team to have someone who's selling out and doing everything for you?
Well, you know, Kaz is a great leader in a lot of ways. And I think that the best way is how hard she works. She emotionally cares more about her teammates than probably anyone I have ever coached before. She is constantly thinking about and worrying about what they think and should she play hard enough? Could she have done more? I like to, you know, she comes in the office and I like to just try to lift the weight of her great being a great teammate and let her be her. Today was the first time in 2021 that I saw from the start of the game to the end of the game where she was her the whole game. And what a great teammate she still is in that. She's willing to pass it off, but she takes it when she's supposed to. She came up with some key knockdowns on the defensive end. Super key draws. You know, we've got a great junior class that when they play well together, I think we can be unstoppable. We're still working towards that 60 minutes thing, as you could see today. But I think we're getting there.
It was an awesome win tonight, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks.
All right, let's bring in Kaitlyn Kozlowski because we were just talking about her. Kaitlyn, we'll switch sides. You can come over here. We're just talking about doing everything, right? How much pride do you have in being able to play in every aspect of the field?
I think it's something that I've been given the cards to have a great athletic career, and it's just using that to my advantage. I've been struggling recently with my confidence, and I've really used my teammates and the coaches to trust in me that I need to keep going, work through my mistakes, and I think that's really helped me. I think that lacrosse is everything that I want to do every day. I mean, it's everything to me, so I just needed to get back to playing lacrosse, having fun, and it worked out tonight.
It was great. All right, we kind of ended up having a small new nickname for you tonight, and I'm going to see if you can understand this. We started calling you Kaitlyn Kozlowski because after the first couple of shots were stopped, You ended up sort of switching up the strategy a little bit the next couple of shots. Take me through how that went, and they all started to seem to fall after that.
Yes, I am a very high-the-high shooter, if that's something obviously everyone knows. So after getting in my head a little bit about the high shots, you know, coach on the sideline, she's like, you got to go low, you got to figure out, and I think that it's not one ear out the other with that once you're two shots in and they're not going. So it's just changing up and what works, works.
Yeah, it worked. It worked all right for four goals. We were talking with coach about what this means. You know, we all know what happened the last time. How much were you guys thinking about that, and how good did it feel to be able to avenge that tonight?
Yeah, it felt really good. I think a lot of us going in, it was emotional more than anything for us, and the mentality going in that we are a completely different team from 2 years ago, and the junior class, my class, the senior class who was here for both, for that, we just know that we're a completely different team, have built so much since that game, and I think we really showed that we have the skills and everything that we need it to take the win home tonight.
All right, who do we need to shout out tonight? Who needs to get some love from you?
Well, we had the fans that helped us a lot, the momentum, but all my grandparents watching at home, my aunt, uncles, all my friends who tune in, it means everything to me that I get the text after the game, and I mean, I play for them over everything, so yeah.
Kaitlyn, congratulations
Thank
on a great you. Win, a great night.
Thank you.
Let's bring in Caroline. Caroline Murphy, all she did tonight was score six goals, which is, by the way, by her standards, kind of a ho-hum night. Caroline, we know who you need to shout out because your mom let us know she was here.
Yep.
We always hear from a bunch of your family tonight. How good did it feel to have your mom back here, to have fans in the stands again at Mustang Stadium?
Oh my gosh, it was so awesome. I was almost like nervous though. It felt like I was a freshman again, and like this is the first time my family's ever seen me play. It was like, I don't know. And with us playing LBC since it was the championship game our freshman year, I was just like really nervous, but it was awesome.
You know, we talked about this final few minutes of the first half. Were you guys carrying some of that in the first half of tonight's game? Were you feeling some of that? And how much did that change the way, I mean, we'll talk about the final shot of the half in a second, but the way that the final few minutes of the half played out?
Yeah, you mean in the first half, the momentum? Yeah, I think that was like, we needed that. That was huge. We went on like a four goal run, I think, and that was to end it. So, yeah, I think that was a huge momentum swing.
Right, you get the ball with like 2 seconds left in the half. What is going through your mind, and what did it mean to see that go in at the buzzer?
I was waiting for Katie to pass it to me. I'm like, pass it to me, pass it to me, pass it to me. And then I just spun and just shot. I honestly was so shocked it went in. I was just as surprised as everybody else.
Yeah, I mean, you almost, by the way, we saw you try another one at the end of the shot clock down here on the other side of the field in a sec. That didn't work out quite as well, obviously. The result was quite as good. But, like, is that something that you work on at all, is taking shots from that distance?
Nope.
I mean, it just worked. It just worked. How good you feel about this team as a whole right now? Obviously, you guys took one on the chin a couple weeks ago, but the way that you've bounced back, facing a really quality opponent tonight, and how good you're playing.
I feel awesome. We were just talking about the amount of turnovers that we had. Even from like last game, I think we've cut it by like 10. So I think we're just clicking on everything, and it was a great team win.
All right. Who else do we need to shout out tonight besides mom?
Whole family.
Whole family. Caroline, congratulations on a great night and a great win.
Thank you.
Caroline Murphy, Kaitlyn Kozlowski, Kathy Railey, appreciate all of them joining us. Stevenson wins 19-14. This is Glenn Clark. Go Mustangsports.tv.